well, we completed our exercise. Does anyone have any thoughts that they wanted to share about the exercise or any insights or any thoughts that you wanted?
I like that. I'm going to suggest that to the Honduras team. I like that exercise.
What about it did you like?
Out.
I should have known.
It's so vulnerable.
I think it's good to for the team to kind of know what you feel is a weakness, and then kind of have that feedback. Because you know some of the things that Allison and I talked about, I was just like, really? Me? You know, so surprised me.
Important to realize that just because we have weaknesses, that is the way God made us, and He can use our weaknesses.
Right. Well,
a lot of times our weaknesses is how we relate to other people.
Yeah.
The irony in what you said, I don't know if irony is the right word, but the coincidence anyway, what you said was that what Alan considered to be a weakness was something that I considered to be a strength in him.
The same thing,
just in a different package, you know. You see it in a different way. And I understand why he thought it was a weakness, and I think he understood why I thought it was a strength.
When Selena and I were talking about it, that's when I read what her weakness was, it seemed like the actual quality, it depends on the use of the quality. Like, you have... the same thing, if it was functioning as the proper tool, it's appropriate. But sometimes we take that and we use that inappropriately. We use it in a not
way. Well, we're always our own worst critic. Like, I mean, this is the same thing, like, it's like, especially with going to the gym, like, this one thing, everybody comes up and they're like, man, you have big shoulders. And I'm like, that's like my worst feature of me. I have tiny shoulders. That's just what you see is you think it's a weakness, but other people see it as a strength. And one thing my buddy always said is, I wish I could see me how other people see me. Because you always look at yourself and you never think you're good enough. But other people compliment you and you appreciate the compliments, but you still don't feel like they're actually true. Because
I like this because we have our idea of what our strengths are. We have what we think we're good at. And then what everybody else thinks we're good at or shows us that we're good at and sees that we're good at may be completely different. And it brings to light for us a new strength and something like, oh, I never really thought about this is what I was good at. This is what I'm strong in. And it can bring to light new things for you and you can continue to grow in those strengths now that you're aware of them.
I think some people like to degrade themselves, and so whenever someone tells them, oh, well, I like this about you, it's kind of encouraging, so that's also really nice.
Yeah.
Anybody else? Okay. Well, we're pretty good on time. I'm excited. Turnabout is fair play. I like that. Tim said last week, which I have on here, he said, prepare to pour your entire self into the trip. That was a note that I made. That's what Tim said. And so for next week, we're going to be doing a worship song. And we are hoping that Josiah is either going to bring a ukulele or his guitar. We're going to be working on that. We'll be doing music. So next week we're going to learn the song Defender. And then if anyone else has any songs that they would like to have probably going to try to have maybe 8 or 10 songs, some songs that we can sing while we're in Haiti. So you kind of want to have what would minister to, pick a favorite for whatever reason, pray about it. What would be good for our trip? What would be good for whatever? So if anyone has any suggestions, we can try to work on that. So next week we'll be doing Defender.
I do have a song I'd like to sing with the Haitian children while we're there.
Okay.
But I wanted to bring this point up about Josiah bringing the ukulele. The first 2 years we went, Caleb was in charge of the music, and Caleb took his ukulele, mm-hmm. and played his ukulele. So that would be something that would be kind of neat tie in to previous trips.
Mm-hmm.
I definitely want to sing the song with the Haitian children about... Making Melodies.
Making Melodies.
You know, the one where you wind up singing like that with your tongue sticking out. Yes, that's on YouTube, by the way. If you search TBC Haiti or something like that on YouTube, you can find it.
It's so fun.
Okay, did anyone have any thoughts on the training with George and Becky?
I wish at some point, and it flies in the face of what I feel like our ultimate mission is with Equipping Haiti, scaling back the size of the trips, because it's difficult to do it that way, but I wish at some point we could all get the opportunity to experience some time in those remote mountains that he talks about. What we will see is bad. I mean, as far as, you can speak to it as far as the poverty, the malnutrition that we see even, then this would be considered, I think you would be considered middle class in Haiti, where we're gonna be, compared to what he saw and what they deal with in those remote mountains. I mean, we won't see very many, if any, kids who have their ribs and then their midsection is sunk into about this wide where you can see the front and back of their spine. We won't see that he's seen already. We won't see kids that are so weak that they're bedridden because they're malnourished. We won't see adults that are in their 30s that look like they're in their 70s and their skin's hanging off their bones because they haven't eaten anything.
Tanks are bad.
Those are things we don't get to see. So I wish that we could all experience that.
Well, that's something we can pray about and figure out how God can work it out. I did want to thank everyone for the love offering. It was a very generous love offering that we were able to give to them. Thank you for your contribution. And I also did give a little bit to Jerry, because it was generous and I thought that would be a blessing. So that's what happened.
I honestly think that's what prompted George to buy us dinner at McDonald's on Sunday night. Well, I mean, I don't know that for sure, but I think that's part of what prompted him to buy us dinner at McDonald's on Sunday night. Because that's just the way he is.
Well, when someone gives you a gift, you should say thank you.
He did.
I know, but I mean, for me, if he wants to buy me dinner and so on, I mean, thank you. Okay. I don't know if I put it on your sheet, but I did, if you guys want to add to your prayer, George and Becky's team will be going to Haiti on June 11th through 20th, so we can definitely be praying for them. And Providence Opry, I did go ahead and give them a love offering to help them out with Haiti, separate gift to help them out with their Haiti mission trip. June 11th through 20th.
Yeah, and they're going up into the mountains.
They're going way into the boonies. Do you remember the name of the city?
I do not. I just know that it was even more remote than you only can get there on foot. It's like a 3 hour backpack. 3 hours of backpacking to get there once you leave your last form of transportation, which is a they'll spend 4 or 5 hours riding up to the up to this place on the back of a motorcycle, and then they'll walk for 3 more hours before they get there. While we're praying for people who are going to Haiti, a friend of mine, I believe, is leaving either tomorrow or the next day to go with Brace for Impact, which is a group that goes to northern Haiti, and they
what's it called?
Brace for Impact. It's actually Brace for Impact 46. It was started by a professional baseball player, and they go to individual homes and help them install toilets at their home. And Todd Goodman, who, if you know Todd, he's Timberline Fisheries down here.
Yeah.
He's making his first trip to Haiti. I contacted him.
Exciting.
I contacted
tomorrow?
Him. I was wanting to think they either leave tomorrow or the next day. I actually saw a post made by Brace for Impact saying, please pray for us. We're taking 11 men are making a trip to Haiti to minister to the people there or whatever.
Our trip seems so far away, but so close.
41 days.
I know, far away, but so close.
See, kids? So that we'll see ya. So this is his first trip. He said it was his first trip. The first trip to Haiti. So I told him to be prepared because it is a life-changing experience.
So we're a little bit over on the 8 o'clock self-enclosed time frame. So we can go ahead and close in prayer. If everyone can scoot in, we can hold hands, and then we'll close.
Do we want to do that, or do we want to pray trip style?
Let's pray trip style. Really intimate.
Come over here. Might ought to change the camera view.
Come over here.
Standing right in front of it.